Let's jump straight into it because there is so much news to get through.
Yeah, there is. It's sort of getting to the business end of the year. And we're going to start this week in the Ovens and King Footy League, where a review was put out a couple of weeks ago now saying that it must lose two of its 14 clubs by the start of next season. The current model isn't sustainable. It's just too many clubs that are too good and not good enough, and there's a big gap in the middle, and they need to do something about it, Tim.
Roslyn, which two teams are in the gun?
Four teams. Four teams from the old Benalla District League. Now, they joined the Ovens and King League in 2010 when the Benalla District League was wound up, so we're talking Goorambat, Tattong, Swanpool and Bonnie Doon. And the other one probably in the mix is Benalla All Blacks, who have really, really struggled this year as well. Now, it all started when Bright applied to transfer from the ONK to the Talangata Footy League last year. That got knocked back, but the VCFL said we need to do a review of that competition because we're struggling a bit up there, and that's what's happening at the moment. Bright still wants to go. The review says no, they should stay for at least next year until they bed down this new 12-team format. But, you know, one of the other really big concerns in this part of the world is there's 14 senior footy teams in that league. There is 5 under 18 teams. So junior footy in that part of the world is a real problem. Numbers is a real problem. So that review is kind of looking at that issue as well.
What about the traffic? I mean, not the traffic. What about the travelling?
Not too much traffic out there. It should be okay.
I'm worried about... You haven't been up there for a while, have you?
I'm always worried about the traffic.
Couple of tractors on the road, which might make things a little
bit... Watch out for the sheep.
But for Bright, yes, travel is a real issue. Like, Bright being in the Owen K League, they travel to Bonnie Doon, which is a 360k round trip. Swanpool and Tattong, both 280k round trips, and Goorambat a 260k round trip. So massive trips, which isn't unique to country footy, really, but there is some seriously long trips and there is some serious issues in that league, and thank God they're finally having a look at them.
Cost of petrol, though.
Yes, absolutely.
Tokemoor, what's happening there?
Yeah, what do you do if you have a vote, a club vote, and you don't get the result you want?
You have another one.
Oh, no.
Correct. That's exactly what you do, and that's what
you try and shift the numbers.
That's not the result we want. Let's do it again,
yeah,
just to be sure.
Do it again.
There's countries that do exactly the same thing. You know that, don't you?
Tokemoor Footy Club will vote a second time on August 15 on its proposed move to the Pocollarone District League. They didn't get the result that they thought they would. They needed a 75% majority and they fell 7% short of that. So a pretty tight vote. And basically there was a few issues with it. One of them being they sent out the ballots to all their club members individually numbered, and a lot of the members cut that off thinking it was the way the committee would know who voted which way.
Right.
So cut the numbers off, which made those votes invalid. So there were some issues with the way it was done. There was also some issues with the information everyone had at hand before they voted and made their decision. So they've all decided, even the people that don't want to transfer to the Pocollarone League agree that there should be a second vote. So that'll be held on August 15 and we're expecting a different result this time.
All right, this one slipped across our desk earlier in the week. I'm not sure that Rosie would be overly happy, but Violet Town have snagged another former AFL player.
Yeah, their third one. It's Ben Johnson, who of course was a Collingwood backman for a very long time and a vet.